First of all, good morning and welcome to all the hosts and participants. Thank you for giving me an opportunity for presenting my lecture on the experiment, which is the Stefan's law verification. Before starting my presentation, I just want to give a special thanks to our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Uttarakhand Open University, Professor OPS Negi sir, for having such an innovative idea in this pandemic COVID-19 scenario. You are all facing some of the difficulties in this present scenario. I want to thank Dr. Kamal Devlal sir. I have not met personally, but the entire session under his guidance has been very much fruitful for all the participants. Even I personally feel that this type of the workshop must be organized in the future as well. And it, because it, this type of the programs are the demand of the time. And I also thanks to the host, mainly Rajesh Matpal sir and Meenakshi ma'am, for giving us an opportunity to present to create an atmosphere, and we will have interactions with the students as well as with the teachers, with the physics fraternity. So I am just here to present the Stefan's law verification. First of all, I am Dr. Vishal Kumar Sharma, Assistant Professor, Physics Department, SSJ Campus, Almora, Kumaon University, Nainital. So we just have proper information about Stefan's law verification. हम पढ़ते भी आए हैं, लेकिन what are the things that are related with the Stefan's law verification? This is very much important for all of us to understand. So first we have the basic information regarding the Stefan's law verification. Just going to the this. So first here, it is visible to all. This now Stefan's law, what we are just going to do here, we are going to verify a law which is called the Stefan's law, and it is connected to the black body radiation. And you just all are aware of the fact that this law simply state that the total energy radiated per unit time per unit area of a black body is proportional to the fourth power of the absolute temperature at which the black body is. So we have the prior information about Stefan's law. It is proportional to the fourth power of the absolute temperature. Now you can just see here this. You can just have now you can just see here the main contribution on which these are the two scientists, Joseph Stefan's and Ludwig Boltzmann. You know that Joseph Stefan's, on which name the Stefan's law is based upon, was a famous physicist, mathematician, and the poet of the Austrian Empire. On the other hand, Ludwig Boltzmann, it is a very great name in the statistical physics, in the entire the physics scenario. You can just say Ludwig Boltzmann was an Austrian physicist, philosopher, and we are aware of the fact that he have the very important development in the statistical mechanics. The entire role of the development of the statistical mechanics, you can just show, has a very great role, has a very great hand of this Boltzmann, Ludwig Boltzmann. You know that, you are aware of the fact that we have the, when we just have information about Boltzmann entropy relationship, we just go to the Boltzmann entropy relationship. So Boltzmann entropy relationship, you can just have, what is the Boltzmann entropy relationship? You know that, what is here, if I just write this as, this is equals to this K, this ln of this here, this is omega here. So you can just see here, what is S here? This S is the entropy, which is a thermodynamical parameter, and omega, this is thermodynamic probability. It is a statistical factor. So the this Boltzmann entropy relationship acts as a bridge between the thermodynamics and the statistical physics. All of you are aware of this basic relationship, already you have studied. And this K, this is the Boltzmann constant, and this is the basic tool of development of the thermodynamics. We can just switch to the, we can have the proper information about the Boltzmann entropy relationship. So this is very important relation in the statistical mechanics as well as in the thermal physics. This is a very great tool for, you can just say, if you have the entropy information, we can just generalize all the parameters which are related to the thermodynamic system. So it is very much great important tool for all the you can just say, have the information about the particular system which we are interacting with that. So on the other hand, let's have the this now. This is the Stefan's law, on which Stefan's law is based upon. These are the important parts of the Stefan's law. We are have the black body radiation. Next one is the emissivity and emissive power, spectral emissive power, which is represented by E lambda, and absorptive power. We will discuss one by one in this sequence. Now we just do the come to the first thing. We have to have black body radiation. What is the radiation? Where the terms radiation has it comes upon? So you are aware of the fact that in thermodynamics, the central parameter is temperature. The temperature is the parameter on which the whole of the thermal physics is based upon. And one of the important heat, both the thermodynamic and the heat are the, you can just say, macroscopic parameters we discussed here. Or when we define heat, heat, you just generally say that heat is the energy in the transit, means energy in the transference. And energy is going to be transferred from one part to another. This is the basic, you are just, there, when we discuss heat, then you can just say, there are three modes of the propagation of the heat. When we just see here, conduction, convection, and the radiation. So you can just see here. So conduction, if we talk about conduction, what is it? You can just see here. Heat is going to be transferred from one part to other through the substance and without the thermal motion of the individual particles. You can just see. Means you just see here. Mainly it is for the solids. When we discuss the convection, जिसे हम फर्स्ट इज कंडक्शन मींस चालन जो आप पढ़ते हुए आए हैं, दिस इज कन्वेक्शन, कन्वेक्शन मींस संवहन, रेडिएशन विकिरण. तो हमने कंडक्शन की बात की, कंडक्शन इज मेनली फॉर द सॉलिड्स. ऑन द अदर हैंड कन्वेक्शन, कन्वेक्शन की अगर हम बात करें, कन्वेक्शन में क्या होगा कि दे रिसीव एक्चुअली मोशन ऑफ द हीटेड पार्टिकल्स, हीटेड पार्टिकल्स आर गोइंग टू मूव. एंड दिस इज मेनली फॉर, यू कैन जस्ट हैव द सॉलिड्स के लिए कंडक्शन होता है, लेकिन जो लिक्विड एंड गैसेस के लिए वी हैव दिस पैरामीटर कन्वेक्शन. ऑन द अदर हैंड रेडिएशन, इट इज आल्सो वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट टूल. वी आर गेटिंग द लाइट फ्रॉम द सन, इट इज इन द टर्म्स ऑफ द रेडिएशन. बट वन थिंग यू हैव टू जस्ट नोटिस हियर, कंडक्शन एंड कन्वेक्शन की अगर हम बात करें तो दीज रिक्वायर्स द मटेरियल मीडियम फिलिंग द स्पेस बिटवीन द सोर्स एंड रिसीवर. के बीच में क्या होना चाहिए? मटेरियल मीडियम होना चाहिए फॉर द first two, means conduction and convection. On the other hand, this radiation, you can just see, no material medium is needed. That is the applicability, so that it can travel through vacuum also. And what about the energy which is going to be radiated by a hot body is termed as the radiant energy. If it is visible to you, what I am trying to show here, this you are just seeing here. What is here? This is the radiation. And the because it is going to be heated, so there are means you can just see here, heat waves are going to be generated. Heat waves, we generally हम ना करके कह करके हम इन्हें क्या कहेंगे? Radiation. More general, more appropriate word is thermal radiation. Mainly हम generally in scientific terms we just see thermal radiation. Thermal means it is depending on the temperature. So it is very important tool for the discussion of this radiation. And you just see here, you just see here, when we discuss conduction, I have mainly told you conduction is totally for the, you just see solid, solid bodies के लिए हम generally conduction को. अब देखिए generally क्या है कि this is suppose it is mainly it is of iron one. So what will happen? It is looking in red color. So you can just see here what will happen in the solid. What will happen? Molecules are not going to move from one to other. What is happening here? Molecules are transferring their energy to the subsequent atoms which is adjacent to the them. मीनिंग टू से दैट जो उसके बगल में उसको अपनी एनर्जी दे रहा है वो दूसरे को ट्रांसफर कर रहा है वो दूसरे को, लेकिन एक्चुअली क्या है? मीन इक्विलिब्रियम वाइब्रेशंस वहां पर हो रहे हैं. मींस मॉलिक्यूल्स आर गोइंग टू बी वाइब्रेट अलोंग देयर मीन इक्विलिब्रियम पोजीशन, बट नॉट दे आर नॉट चेंजिंग देयर पोजीशन. पोजीशन आर नॉट गोइंग टू बी चेंज इन दिस सिनेरियो. ऑन द अदर हैंड वी जस्ट सी ए कन्वेक्शन. कन्वेक्शन जनरली सपोज वी हैव इन द दिस पैन वी हैव द वॉटर एंड वॉटर इज गोइंग टू बी warm by this one. So what do you just see here? This arrow, what will happen when these molecules which are situated lowest part of the this pot, what will happen when they get heated? They change their position and go to the upper part. Generally aapne dekha hoga, generally aap when we just try to warm the water, generally hum log jab pani garam karte hain uske isme kya hota hai, generally you will just see here What will happen? Molecules are going to shift their position. Means I have earlier told you, according to the definition of convection, convection में मैंने बताया, actual motion of the heated particles. Heated particles क्या कर रहे हैं? Motion कर रहे हैं. तो you just see here, molecules are going to be change their position in the convection here. So you just see here, arrow, यहां से ये particle क्या हुआ? उठ करके ये ऊपर चले गया. Now, what will happen on the other hand? This is the, you just see here, this is the colder. So it comes to the lower part. And again, this process is going on, and until you will just see reach to the situation when all the hot water is going to be warm here. So this is the main phenomenon which I am going to discuss. This the conduction, convection, and radiation. I hope you have understand that the three terms which are very basic and you are all familiar. Nothing new in this conduction, convection, and radiation. Now just switch to the next one. So according to Maxwell, the thermal radiations, you generally know, thermal radiations means generally kya honge, there is a transfer of heat. And you know that heat is going to be transferred from a hot body to a cold body without appreciable heating of the medium. Generally, tab tak heat flow hoti hai whenever there is a thermal equilibrium condition is going to be achieved. So we are having, up generally heat or thermal energy is propagated by radiation. Generally, jo heat ya thermal energy ki agar hum baat kare, wo kya hua? रेडिएशन से प्रोपगेट होते हैं जनरली, जस्ट लाइक द लाइट. लाइट जो जनरली प्रोपगेट होती है बिकॉज इट इज सपोज टू बी द रेडिएशन एज एंड दिस इज सपोज टू बी द इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव. ये जनरली क्या होती है? इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव की तरफ प्रोपगेट होती है. कौन? रेडिएशन. एंड हैविंग द सिमिलरिटी विद द लाइट. लाइट इज ऑल्सो एन इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक. इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक मीन्स इलेक्ट्रिक एंड मैग्नेटिक. दीज आर as my means Rajesh Matpal sir has already told you about, there are the, when we have this direction of the propagations, he just have shown to you. I was seeing his lecture, then he have already told you electromagnetic means E and B are perpendicular to each other, and there is a means on the, what is the direction of propagation of the that particular wave will be perpendicular to both E and B. That will be the means. Suppose x की तरफ हमने e लिया हुआ, y की तरफ suppose b है, तो actually क्या होगा? जो z direction होगी, that will be the direction of the wave propagation. So I think you have understand this one, and now just going to the next one. So thermal radiations, I have earlier told you, have electromagnetic wave nature, and because of having electromagnetic wave nature, it can, you can just say, travels through empty space or vacuum. And what is the speed of light? Speed of light, agar hum baat karte, speed of light generally kya hoti hai? Ki speed of light, generally jab hum baat karte, what is the speed of light? It is generally 3 into this, you just know, it is 10 raised to power, this 8 meter per second ki, jo actual mein hota, this 10 here, actually you just have this 10 meter per second se, थोड़ा ड्राइंग में थोड़ी सी दिक्कत है बिकॉज वी आर नॉट सो मच फेमिलियर विद दिस बिग वेव. ऑल इन दिस सिनेरियो वी आर प्रेजेंटिंग इन दिस केस, सो यू आर अवेयर ऑफ दिस वन. दिस इज वेलोसिटी ऑफ लाइट इज 3 × 10⁸ मीटर पर सेकेंड. सो ऑल ऑफ यू आर अवेयर विद दिस द वेव इज गोइंग टू बी प्रोपोगेट. इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव प्रोपोगेट्स विद दिस अमाउंट ऑफ द स्पीड. So like light, thermal radiations travel in the straight line. You have not seen any of the light. Light, agar hum baat karte, generally wo kya? Means never you have seen a curved path. Light always travels in the straight line. You just switch on the torch. Torch ki roshni agar aap dekho, generally you will just see here. There is a, you will just see straight line. So radiations also travels in the straight line. And when we discuss thermal radiations, so thermal radiations have the same property as I have earlier told you with the help of the light. So it also travels in the straight line. So you can just have this one. On other hand, thermal radiation obeys the inverse square law. Inverse square law means, meaning to say that, what is the meaning to say inverse square law? All the law which are proportional to this, you can just have, jab hum inverse square law means there is the proportionality of 1 upon this R square. So these are the inverse square law, and you are aware of the fact that when we discuss Coulomb's law or central forces, jitne bhi central forces the, wo kya hote hain? Inverse square law ko follow karte hain. So these are the thermal radiations also obeys the inverse square law. And like light, you know that light purges the reflection interference and polarization phenomenon. So you can just see here. So in this case, we can just have, so you just see, light is also going to be follow the reflection, refraction, interference, diffraction, and polarization phenomena. So thermal radiation is also going to exhibit these type of the properties. You can just say here. So properties are going to be followed with the help of this thermal radiations also possesses the properties of the light. You can just say here. Now we just know to go to the next section. In general, you have known that thermal radiation has the same nature as that of light. जो thermal radiations होते हैं वो light की तरह ही nature है, जैसे मैंने अभी discuss भी किया, so same nature को क्या कर रहे हैं, follow कर रहे हैं. तो in the electromagnetic, अब generally हम बात कर लेते हैं कि where is this spectrum in the electromagnetic, where is the position of the thermal radiations. So you can just, you know the visible light. Visible light have the combination 7 colors, V, I, B, G, Y, O, R. It starts with violet, ends with the red one. So when we discuss thermal radiations, it is just you next to the red of the visible light with wavelength greater than the red color, and it is called the infrared region. Means just next to the, you can just red end of the, means red end ke just bagal mein kaun sa infrared region hai. So the thermal radiations are going to be in this infrared region of the electromagnetic spectrum. Electromagnetic spectrum बहुत बड़ा broad spectrum है. Visible light की generally हम जिसे senses कर सकते हैं, तो generally वो हम जो electromagnetic spectrum की अगर हम बात करते हैं, तो उसमें जो हमारे thermal radiations हैं, generally we in scientific terms we just name them infrared region में. We just have this, the thermal radiations are going to be placed upon. Now thermal radiations को जैसे मैंने अभी कहा, they are supposed to be the infrared radiations, and they have the wavelength which are ranging from 8000 tangstrom to 4000 tangstrom. This is the particular wavelength corresponding to the thermal radiations, and these are called the infrared radiations. अब generally अगर हम बात करें, तो generally जो हम thermal radiations की बात करते हैं, तो we can just say here, thermal radiations cannot be detected by eye or the photographic plate, but they can be detected by a device which is called the bolometer. Ab actually bolometer hota kya, maine likha bhi yahan par, it measures the change in the resistance with the thermal with temperature. To ye kya karega, jo change hoga kisme, resistance mein, kiske respect mein, temperature ke resistance mein, to wo kya batayega, it is just known to be the bolometer. Ab generally bolometer, so you just know that it is a device for measuring the, means actually हम क्या कर सकते हैं, बोलोमीटर एक ऐसी डिवाइस है जो क्या करती है, मीजर द पावर ऑफ द इंसिडेंट इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन. अब जनरली कैसे, जो इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन पर पढ़ेंगे तो क्या होगा, देयर शुड बी द हीटिंग, हीटिंग ऑफ ए मटेरियल विद करेस्पॉन्डिंग विद द टेम्परेचर. सो एंड इट इज डिपेंडेंट विद द इलेक्ट्रिकल रेजिस्टेंस. सो यू कैन जस्ट से हियर कि बोलोमीटर क्या है, इज ए डिवाइस जिससे हम मेजर क्या कर रहे हैं, वी आर मेजरिंग द पावर ऑफ द इंसिडेंट इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन. तो इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन से क्या होगा, देयर शुड बी द करेस्पॉन्डिंग ऑफ द टेम्परेचर, और टेम्परेचर डिपेंडेंट इलेक्ट्रिक रेजिस्टेंस इज गोइंग टू बी. सो व्हाट डू हैपन, मेजर्स द चेंज इन द रेजिस्टेंस विद द टेम्परेचर. ऑन द अदर हैंड ऑल्सो यू कैन जस्ट से हियर, इट यूजेस द टेम्परेचर सेंसिटिव रेजिस्टिव एलिमेंट. ये एक्चुअली टेम्परेचर सेंसिटिव जो रेजिस्टिव एलिमेंट होता है, whose resistance changes with the temperature, that is the function of the bolometer. Bolometer का ये function है, वो क्या करता है, actually जो temperature sensitive resistance है, या you can just say changes, वो क्या होता है, temperature. For example, there are thermistor and barometer are the example of commonly used resistive element जो generally used होते हैं. I have also told you, shown to you, there is a thermopile. Thermopile, it is a thermoelectric difference device. Sorry. It is a thermoelectric device. Thermopile actually क्या करता है? It is an electric device that converts the thermal energy into electrical energy. ये actual किसमें कर रहा है? जो thermal energy है, उसको किसमें convert कर रहा है? Electrical energy में. And it is composed of several thermocouples connected usually in the series or parallel. Less commonly, generally you can parallel में तो बहुत कम combination, लेकिन in series thermocouples क्या होते हैं? Attached होते हैं. So thermopile जो है, थर्मोपाइल में, थर्मोपाइल और थर्मोकपल में अंतर क्या है? थर्मोकपल इज ए थर्मो इलेक्ट्रिक डिवाइस. ऑन द अदर हैंड थर्मोपाइल इज ए, इट इज ए कपल ऑफ सेवरल थर्मोकपल्स कनेक्टेड यूजुअली इन द सीरीज. सो दिस इज द instrument by which thermal radiations can be detected. So I think this must have been useful. Chalni, pyrometer is also with which we measure the radiations, power of the radiations. We measure with the pyrometer. So going to the, this is the our important topic, black body. अब जल्दी ब्लैक बॉडी होती क्या है. यू कैन जस्ट से ब्लैक बॉडी ऐसी बॉडी है जिस पर कितने भी इंसिडेंट रेडिएशन सब सब क्या हो जाते हैं, इट एब्जॉर्ब्स. यू कैन जस्ट से अकॉर्डिंग टू योर डेफिनेशन आई हैव ऑलरेडी नोटेड डाउन फॉर यू कि ब्लैक बॉडी क्या है, एक आइडियल बॉडी है जो क्या कर रही है, होल ऑफ द इंसिडेंट रेडिएशन टू पास इन टू इन सेल्फ विदाउट रिफ्लेक्टिंग द एनर्जी. कोई भी एनर्जी क्या हो रही है, रिफ्लेक्ट नहीं हो रही है. क्यों क्यों नहीं हो रही, बिकॉज एब्जॉर्ब्स विद इन इट सेल्फ this whole incident radiation. So generally kya ho raha hai, without reflecting the energy, whole of the incident radiations are going to be absorbed. Incident radiations sare ke sare kya ho ja rahe hain, absorbed ho ja rahe hain. And this I just see here, what suppose any of the incident radiation is coming inside this enclosure we have created for showing the black body. What you just see, there are the multiple reflections. After the multiple reflections, you just see here धीरे धीरे क्या होगा, ये एक्चुअली कंप्लीटली एब्जॉर्ब हो, जो इंसिडेंट रेडिएशन आया था वो धीरे धीरे, यू विल जस्ट सी हियर आफ्टर द मल्टीपल रिफ्लेक्शंस ऑल ऑफ द इंसिडेंट रेडिएशन इज गोइंग टू बी एब्जॉर्ब विद इन द बॉडी. दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड द ब्लैक बॉडी, बिकॉज नथिंग इज गोइंग टू बी, जितना आया सब का सब इसके अंदर समा गया. दिस इज द ब्लैक बॉडी. यू जस्ट हैव This property is valid for radiation corresponding to the all wavelength. So, particularly wavelength, कोई specific wavelength नहीं है, बल्कि it is corresponding to all wavelength. जिस भी wavelength तक ही radiation आएगी, it is going to be absorbed and no particular specific angle is needed. Means इसी angle पर जाएगा तभी absorb होगा. This is not the criteria when we discuss the black body. Black body means you can just see here, किसी भी respective wavelength का हो और साथ ही साथ क्या हो, किसी भी एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस पर हो, होल ऑफ द रेडिएशन इज गोइंग टू बी एब्जॉर्ब. सो वी जस्ट से ब्लैक बॉडी इज एन आइडियल एब्जॉर्बर ऑफ इंसिडेंट रेडिएशन. जो इंसिडेंट रेडिएशन है सारे के सारे क्या है, उसको एब्जॉर्ब किया. दैट्स व्हाई इट इज द आइडियल एब्जॉर्बर ऑफ द इंसिडेंट रेडिएशन. नाउ इन प्रैक्टिस वी जस्ट सी व्हाट इज द कंस्ट्रक्शन, हाउ इट कैन बी बिल्ट. सो यू जस्ट हैव lamp black and platinum black are the two substances which are showing nearest approach to the black body. Jo kya karte hain, black body ki tarah you just nearest approach, not 100%, but they are nearest to the black body. So in practice perfect black body to available nahi hai, lekin lamp black aur jo platinum black hai wo kya hai, these are the nearest approach of the black body. You can just see here, I am just telling you about the configuration of the black body. Already Wien's black body, this can have Macon or Ferris black body, I think you have studied. So this is the particular configuration of the black body. Now we just see here ki hum generally ab black body ki to baat kar li humne, what is a black body radiation. So black body radiation, you just say here, it is when a black body is at uniform temperature, its emission has a characteristic frequency distribution that depends on the temperature. And jo frequency distribution hai, jo kis par depend kar raha hai, temperature par. To wahan se jo emission ho raha hai wo kya hai, this is the black body radiation. Koi bhi black body, it is suppose at a uniform temperature hai, to wahan jo emission hoga with a characteristic frequency distribution, wo kis par depend kar raha hai, depending on the temperature and the emission is called, this is the black body radiation. So it is the term black body radiation has been coined because the emission is associated with the black body, and that emission is characteristic on the frequency distribution, and that frequency distribution depending on the temperature, and this emission is called the black body radiation. Now these radiations, agar hum baat kare, they are independent of what, nature of the substance par bhi depend nahi karte hain, nature of the walls of the enclosure us par bhi depend nahi karenge, and the presence of any other body in the enclosure us par depend nahi karenge. Mainly नेचर ऑफ द सब्सटेंस पर भी डिपेंड नहीं कर रहा है, नेचर ऑफ द वॉल्स पर भी डिपेंड नहीं कर रहा है, एंड द प्रेजेंस ऑफ एनी अदर बॉडी पर भी डिपेंड नहीं कर रहा है. बट वेयर इट डिपेंड्स ओनली ऑन द टेम्परेचर. किस पर डिपेंड कर रहा है? टेम्परेचर पर ही डिपेंड करता है क्या? ब्लैक बॉडी जो रेडिएशन हो रहे हैं. नाउ वी गो टू द, आई हैव टोल्ड यू इमिसिविटी एंड इमिसिव पावर. दीज आर ऑल्सो द टर्म्स विच आर रिलेटेड विद द ब्लैक बॉडी. सो यू जस्ट, आई हैव अर्लियर एक्सप्लेन्ड यू, ए ब्लैक बॉडी क्या है? इज एन आइडियल इमिटर. इमिटर इन द सेंस दैट जो एनर्जी इमिटेड बाई एनी रियल सर्फेस इज लेस देन द एनर्जी इमिटेड बाई ए ब्लैक बॉडी एट द सेम टेम्परेचर. जो अगर एनर्जी इमिटेड देखें किसी रियल सर्फेस पर और ब्लैक बॉडी के सर्फेस, जो एनर्जी किस में होगी? जो रियल सर्फेस की ब्लैक एनर्जी होगी वो क्या होगी? इट विल बी लेस देन द एनर्जी इमिटेड बाई ए ब्लैक बॉडी करेस्पॉन्डिंग टू सेम टेम्परेचर. सेम टेम्परेचर पर है तो जो ब्लैक बॉडी की जो एनर्जी इमिट होगी वो क्या होगी? ज्यादा होगी. एट ए डिफाइंड टेम्परेचर ए ब्लैक बॉडी हैज ए हाईएस्ट मोनोक्रोमेटिक इमिसिव पावर एट ऑल वेवलेंथ. सो किसी पर्टिकुलर डिफाइंड टेम्परेचर को हम ये कह सकते हैं कि जो ब्लैक बॉडी होगी उसके पास क्या होगा? हाईएस्ट मोनोक्रोमेटिक इमिसिव पावर होगी करेस्पॉन्डिंग टू द ऑल द वेवलेंथ. सो दिस इज द इमिस. नाउ व्हाट इज द इमिसिव पावर जो इससे इमिसिविटी से रिलेटेड है? मैंने कहा ब्लैक बॉडी क्या है? आइडियल इमिटर है. तो इमिसिव पावर क्या हो जाएगी भाई? नाउ इमिसिव पावर कैन बी डिफाइंड एज द टोटल थर्मल एनर्जी रेडिएटेड बाय द सरफेस पर यूनिट टाइम पर यूनिट एरिया ओवर ऑल वेवलेंथ्स एंड इन ऑल डायरेक्शन. तो इमिसिव पावर को हम इस तरह से डिफाइन करते कि जो टोटल जो क्या है, जो थर्मल एनर्जी रेडिएट हो रही है किसी सर्फेस से पर यूनिट टाइम पर यूनिट एरिया पर फॉर ऑल द वेवलेंथ्स एंड इन ऑल डायरेक्शन, दिस इज द इमिसिव पावर. It is not emissive power, it is the total emissive power. Total thermal energy की बात कर रहे हैं, ठीक है? तो total emissive power, it also depends on the temperature, material and the surface condition. So किस पर depend कर रहा है? ये depend कर रहा है किस पर? Temperature पर depend कर रहा है, material and the surface conditions पर depend करता है. Now next, what is the spectral emissive power? अब भाई स्पेक्ट्रल इमिसिव पावर, इट इज आल्सो रिलेटेड. स्पेक्ट्रल मींस आई हैव जस्ट प्लॉट ए ग्राफ. व्हाट इज द ग्राफ सिग्निफाइज? दिस इज द, यू जस्ट सी हियर रेडिएशन वेवलेंथ लैम्डा एंड द स्पेक्ट्रल इमिसिव पावर. आई हैव जस्ट प्लॉटेड ए ग्राफ एट डिफरेंट टेम्परेचर्स. एज यू जस्ट सी हियर, दिस इज 3000 केल्विन, 3500, 4000 एंड दिस इज 4500 केल्विन. दीज आर द करेस्पॉन्डिंग टेम्परेचर्स एंड for this we have the spectral emissive power and this radiation wavelength. So spectral emissive power ko hum kaise define karenge? Ye kya hai actually? This is the rate at which the radiation of wavelength lambda is emitted in all direction from the surface per unit wavelength d lambda about lambda. To spectral emissive power jo hum keh rahe hain e lambda, wo kya hai? This is the rate of radiation of range where lambda 2 d lambda emitted through unit area of the material divided by this d lambda. So this is the spectral emissive power. So it is clear to you. Now just going to the next slide. What is the absorptive power? When we discuss the absorptive power, so jaise emissive power hota hai usi tarah kya hoti hai? Absorptive power hoti hai. So you can just see here, when heat is incident on the surface, किसी ऑब्जेक्ट की जो सरफेस होगी अगर उस पर क्या होगा? हीट जो इंसिडेंट हो रहा है, तो यू जस्ट सी हियर ए पार्ट ऑफ इट इज एब्जॉर्ब्ड एंड रिमेनिंग पार्ट इज रिफ्लेक्टेड. किरचॉफ्स लॉ में जनरली पढ़ते हैं, तो किरचॉफ्स लॉ जनरली क्या है? वो क्या होता है? ई लैम्डा अपॉन एल लैम्डा, दिस इज टोटल ई लैम्डा करेस्पॉन्डिंग टू दिस. तो जनरली क्या है कि कोई भी इंसिडेंट रेडिएशन अगर किसी सर्फेस या ऑब्जेक्ट के सर्फेस पर इंसिडेंट हो रहा है तो क्या होगा? Some part of it going to be absorbed and remaining part is going to be reflected. So you just see here, usually the absorbed radiation is converted to the thermal energy, increasing the object's temperature. So क्या करेगा? जो radiation incident वो किसमें convert हो जाते हैं? Absorbed radiation वो generally क्या करेगा? Convert हो जाएगा किसमें? Thermal energy में. And by converting into thermal energy, meaning to say that it is going to be increase the temperature. So a black body, for instance, absorbs all the incident radiations and its absorptive power is 1. सो ब्लैक बॉडी की जो एब्जॉर्प्टिव पावर होगी वो क्या होगी, ऑलवेज इट इज इक्वल टू वन ईयर, एंड बिकॉज इट एब्जॉर्ब्स ऑल ऑफ द इंसिडेंट रेडिएशन, सारे के सारे इंसिडेंट रेडिएशन जो इस पर पड़ेंगे सबको क्या कर लेगा, ये एब्जॉर्ब कर लेता है. दिस इज द एब्जॉर्प्टिव पावर ऑफ द ब्लैक बॉडी. सो स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप डियर पार्टिसिपेंट्स, ये तो मैंने आपको बेसिक बताया कि हम जो स्टीफंस लॉ वेरिफिकेशन, इसमें जो टर्मिनोलॉजी यूज होती है, एक्चुअली स्टीफंस लॉ रेडिएशन की बात अगर हम करें तो बिना ब्लैक बॉडी की बात किए बिना, या रेडिएशन की बात किए बिना, या रेडिएशन से जितने भी पैरामीटर्स अगर हम उनको स्किप करें तो इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी अंडरस्टूड. इट कैन बी अंडरस्टूड वेरी वेल अंटिल एंड अनलेस वी जस्ट नो प्रॉपर थ्योरी. अगर आप देखें किसी एक्सपेरिमेंट को करने के लिए स्टूडेंट्स क्या करते हैं, जनरली एम्फसाइज ऑन व्हाट इज द फंक्शनलिटी. तो जनरली क्या करना चाहिए, स्टूडेंट्स क्या करते हैं, बस उन्हें एपरेटस दे दिया गया, उन्होंने रीडिंग ले ली, बस उन्होंने दिखा दिया, काम खत्म. बट दिस इज नॉट द प्रैक्टिकल. प्रॉपर अगर प्रैक्टिकल करना है तो यू जस्ट नो द इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स, व्हाट इज द इंस्ट्रूमेंट, व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ द इंस्ट्रूमेंट, इंस्ट्रूमेंट काम कैसे करते हैं, एंड what is the theory behind the particular experiment. Kyunki all the things of which are happening in the nature, there is certain physical correspondence. Jitni bhi cheeze nature mein ho rahi hain, actually kya hai, there is some physics behind it, and we are here to discuss about the physics. Generally jo aap dekh rahe hain ki jo workshop ka main uddeshya kya hai, ki going to teach the students with virtual setup. जो इस इंटायर सेटअप का ये एम है मेनली, कि हम कैसे जो हर बच्चे तक कैसे पहुंचे, और कैसे हम उनको मोटिवेट करें, कैसे उनको चीजें हम सिखा पाए, दिस इज द इंटायर. बट लेकिन दिस इज द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स एज वेल, कि आप चीजों को समझे, एंड दिस कैन बी लर्न व्हेन यू स्टडी. सो आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू हियर टेल अस अबाउट व्हाट आर द when we perform the Stephen's law. I have earlier told you what are the significance relations, जो parameters related थे Stephen's law verification से, वो मैंने आपको बता दिए हैं. Now we just object, जो mainly है मुझे practical जो यहाँ पर discuss करना है. तो जनरली स्टूडेंट्स सबसे पहले तो होता है ऑब्जेक्ट. जैसे जनरली व्हेन यू आर टाइपिंग योर सीवी, व्हाट कम्स फर्स्ट, योर नेम एंड ऑब्जेक्ट हियर हियर. तो जनरली क्या है, जब आप अपनी सीवी टाइप करते हैं तो सबसे पहले तो आप अपना नाम लिखते हैं. तो जनरली इन दिस वन ऑल्सो वी आर हियर द ऑब्जेक्ट. ऑब्जेक्ट क्या है, वी हैव टू वेरीफाई द स्टीफंस लॉ ऑफ रेडिएशन. जनरली रेडिएशन बता दिया मैंने, स्टीफंस लॉ भी बता दिया. अब जनरली थोड़ा सा इसको डिस्कस करते हैं कि स्टीफंस लॉ वेरिफिकेशन जो हम कर रहे हैं, एक्चुअल में हम क्लासरूम या प्रैक्टिकल रूम में हम उसको कैसे परफॉर्म करेंगे. सो दिस इज द माय रिस्पांसिबिलिटी टू टीच यू अबाउट हाउ वी जस्ट परफॉर्म द स्टीफंस लॉ ऑफ रेडिएशन इन द लैब. सो सेकेंड थिंग कम्स नेक्स्ट टू द ऑब्जेक्ट इज एपरेटस यूज्ड. व्हाट आर द इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स यूज्ड या एपरेटस यूज्ड, हमें कौन कौन से जो एपरेटस यूज होते हैं. सो फर्स्ट थिंग, दिस इज 6 वोल्ट बैटरी जो चाहिए हमें. Then we have the DC voltmeter, which is in 0 to 10 volts, and DC emitter, which is having a range 0 to 1 ampere. And along with this, we have the electrical bulb having tungsten filament. I will explain why this is the tungsten filament. हम tungsten filament क्यों ले रहे हैं? उसको भी मैं आपको explain करूँगा. In accordance with that, we need the rheostat. Generally, rheostat हम generally usually you just see all the above components are generally you arrange in a single cabinet as well. I will just show the proper diagram of that as well. So let's proceed. These are the apparatus used, I have told you. Now next, what is the theory? Kyunki object dekh liya aapne, apparatus used. Now theory and the formula used. Ab generally thoda yahan par bhi baat kar lete hain ki agar hum black bodies ki baat humne ki hai, Stephen's law ko generally humne jaan liya tha. Suppose we have a body which is situated at temperature T. Along with this, here we have another body which is in the surrounding of this body which is at temperature T, and the surrounded this body has a temperature T naught. Then this E, what is E here? this is the amount of net amount of radiation emitted per second per unit area by a body at temperature T is given by, जो यहाँ पर E है, क्या है? It is the net amount of radiation emitted, H is equals to sigma, this is T raised to power 4 minus T naught raised to power 4. So you just see here, with sigma, this is called the Stefan's constant. So generally Stefan's law, which is have shown you by this equation 1, ब्लैक बॉडी जो के लिए जो स्टीफन्स लॉ जनरली है वो हम क्या ले रहे हैं, व्हाट इज हियर ईच सिग्मा टाइम्स ऑफ दिस टी रेज टू पावर 4 माइनस टी नॉट रेज टू पावर 4, सो इन अलोंग विद दिस दिस इज द नेट अमाउंट ऑफ रेडिएशन इमिटेड पर सेकेंड. सो वी जस्ट सी हियर नाउ दिस वॉज द रिलेशन ऑफ द स्टीफन्स लॉ. सपोज इन क्लोज प्रॉक्सिमिटी देर इज ए सिमिलर रिलेशन कैन ऑल्सो होल्ड फॉर बॉडी दैट आर नॉट ब्लैक. I will just show you in this. Suppose we have a similar relations. हम उसी तरह लिख सकते हैं. Suppose the bodies are not black. So in such case, we can write P here. P is equals to C times of this T alpha minus T naught raised to power alpha here. What is P here? P is the total power. Actually, P क्या है? Total power. किसके द्वारा? Emit हो रही है जब by ये body at a temperature T surrounded by another body at temperature T naught with alpha. If we just see the previous one, alpha is, we can just take to 4 here. So we can just have alpha is a power which is quite close to 4 and C is the constant depending on the material and area of the such body. So generally, हमने क्या किया है? यहाँ पर भी हम एक similar relations establish कर सकते हैं Stefan's law की तरह ही, जहाँ जो क्या है bodies are not black. तो उसके case के लिए हमने ये equation 2 आपको समझाया. Now coming to the next slide. Again, the previous equation which was, if you just see here, P is C times of T alpha minus T naught raised to power alpha. This can be written like this. If I just take T alpha common inside the bracket, what will be the term here? 1 minus T naught raised to power alpha. This will be the numerator, and in the denominator, I will just have this T raised to power alpha here. So if you just take T alpha common of the previous equation, like this equation, this is equation 2 here. If you just take T alpha common, what will be the inside the bracket? Bracket, the remaining term will be C T to power alpha times of this 1 minus T naught raised to power alpha, and this is upon T alpha here. Now, if suppose we are saying that T is very, very greater than T naught, means temperature of the body is very, very greater than, which is the nearest body, jo T naught temperature hai, jo surrounded hai, iske surrounding mein jo body hai, wo uska temperature kya hai? To agar hum maane ki body ka jo temperature, it is very, very much greater as compared to T naught, when then the T is 1500 Kelvin and T naught is 300 Kelvin. So we can write, because this term, agar hum ye dekhe, this term is going to be less than unity. If we just place the values, this term is going to be less than unity. So we can neglect this term and we are left with the result. P is, this equals to C T to the power alpha. So it is clear to you. Now, if you just take log on the both sides, you just see here log P, this equals to alpha log of T plus log C here. And you just see here initial conditions, this log C becomes zero. And when we just plot a graph between log P and log T, it should be a straight line. And the slope of this log P and log T gives us the value of alpha. Clear to you by this? Now coming to the next one. When we are going to verify Stefan's law, we have to measure the following two parameters. What are the parameters? First thing, we have to determine the power radiated. क्योंकि मैंने अभी जो relation आपको दिखाया वो क्या था? P के term में था. तो we have to discuss what is the power radiated. Power radiated. तो generally in this experiment हम क्या लेते हैं? Generally we just take a radiating body which is of tungsten bulb. Tungsten जो bulb होता है, तो generally हम क्या कहते हैं? उसको हम मानते हैं क्या है? It is the radiating body here in the tungsten bulb, and in the steady state we can have the power. Power can be calculated by noting down V and I. V stand for the voltage, I stand for the current, and you know the basic formula. What is the power? P is equals to V into I, and power is expressed in watts. So in this consideration, we are neglecting power lost in the leads and through the gas in the bulb. So this is the power radiated. On the other hand, second parameter, which is the temperature of the radiating body, which I am considering at T here. जो temperature radiating body का है, जो हमने T माना हुआ है. So in this experiment, we are just going to measure the temperature of the tungsten filament. तो उसको measure करने के लिए, this can be measured by measuring the resistance of the filament. तो उसको measure करना है tung, क्योंकि temperature measure करना है, लेकिन उसके लिए this can be achieved only we have the resistance of the filament. हमें किसकी वैल्यू चाहिए? जब रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ जो फिलामेंट का होगा उसके लिए RT. सो वी हैव दिस रिलेशन RT इक्वल्स टू R नॉट 1 प्लस अल्फा T प्लस दिस बीटा T स्क्वायर, वेयर अल्फा एंड बीटा आर द कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ थर्मल एक्सपेंशन हियर एंड नो फॉर द टंगस्टन वी कैन फाइंड द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द फिलामेंट. तो जल्दी हम क्या कर सकते हैं, जो फिलामेंट का टेम्परेचर है वो हम नोन कर सकते हैं बाई नोविंग द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द फिलामेंट. सो लेट्स प्रोसीड. But one serious limitations in this experiment or in this measurement is R0. What is R0? R0 actually hai kya? This is the resistance of the filament. Kis temperature par? At 0 degree centigrade, or you just generally say that 273 Kelvin per. So one can write R0 R 273. So actually jo R0 hai kya? Resistance of the filament hai kis par? 0 degree centigrade. At very small current, VI ratio will give filament resistance as well as lead resistance. जो VI ratio वो क्या देगा हमें? Will give us the filament resistance as well as lead resistance. So in order to calculate R naught, we have to measure the resistance RG. ये resistance RG क्या है? ये उस समय होगा जब when the filament first start glowing. So this is the condition when जो हमने radiating body ली हुई है, जो bulb है उसमें जो filament है किसका, tungsten का जो filament है, वो क्या करेगा, starts glow करना शुरू करेगा. So this is the particular resistance and at which temperature, the temperature is approximately 800 Kelvin पर ये glow होता है. तो what is this is the value of RG. So it is clear R0, then we have this RG actually क्या है, this is the filament temperature. Tungsten का जो filament लगा उसका कब का temperature? When just is first start glowing. So it is clear to you. Now coming to the next one. At this temperature, contribution of lead resistance becomes smaller, and it becomes smaller by a factor of you just almost 4, as compared with that at 273 Kelvin. Therefore, measurement of RG, which is the corresponding R800. Why R800? Because 800 Kelvin मैंने आपको बताया कि उसके लिए जो measurement हम कर रहे हैं RG, and using the computed factor of this RG upon R naught कह लीजिए या R800 upon R273 के लिए, a more accurate value of R0 is going to be found here. So this is the पर्टिकुलर कॉन्फ़िगरेशन जो हम इसमें ले रहे हैं आरजी और आर नॉट को, वो मैंने आपको यहां पर समझाया. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस हियर द प्रिंसिपल एज वेल, व्हाट इज द फिनोमेनन बिहाइंड, मतलब कैसे क्या चीजें इसमें हो रही हैं. इट इज मस्ट मोर टू हैव अंडरस्टैंडिंग अबाउट व्हाट इज द फिनोमेनन्स आर गोइंग टू बिहाइंड दिस कंसिडरेशन. अब जनरली क्या होगा, जब इलेक्ट्रिक करेंट इज गोइंग टू फ्लो द फिलामेंट इन ए लाइट बल्ब, द फिलामेंट हीट्स अप. तो एक्चुअली क्या होगा, जब इलेक्ट्रिक करंट फ्लो होगा किसमें, फिलामेंट में, तो लाइट बल्ब क्या होगा, जो उसका फिलामेंट है वो हीट अप हो जाएगा. तो उस केस में क्या होगा, फिलामेंट लॉसेस हीट इन टू वेज. जो फिलामेंट है एक्चुअली, जो टंगस्टन का फिलामेंट है, वो दो तरीकों से अपनी ही हीट को क्या कर सकता है, लॉस करता है. फर्स्ट वे इज द इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन, एंड यू नो दैट मेनली विजिबल लाइट एंड इनविजिबल हीट रेडिएशन. तो दो तरीकों से फिलामेंट लॉस हीट करता है, एक तो इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन है जो मेनली विजिबल लाइट एंड इनविजिबल रेडिएशन के तौर में होता है, एंड सेकेंड थिंग द कंडक्शन थ्रू द बेस ऑफ द बल्ब, क्योंकि वहां से भी क्या हुआ, कुछ ना कुछ क्या होगा, हीट लॉस आर गोइंग टू बी. दो दीज आर द टू फिनोमेनन्स, इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन एंड द कंडक्शन बाय विच द फिलामेंट लॉसेज द देयर हीट. सो द हीट कंडक्टेड अवे फ्रॉम द फिलामेंट increases linearly with the filament temperature. जो heat यहाँ पर जो conduct हो रही है filament से, वो क्या हो रहा है, वो क्या हो रही है, increase करता है linearly किसके साथ, temperature के साथ. तो generally that is the air in the bulb is pumped out during the manufacture, so no heat is lost by convection. तो only conduction है, electromagnetic radiation के form में totally जो heat है यहाँ पर क्या हो रही है, वो क्या हो रही है, radiate हो जा रही है. मतलब you can just say heat lost हो रही है electromagnetic radiation और conduction. क्योंकि generally मैंने जब radiation वाला part discuss किया था तो मैंने बताया था conduction, convection and radiation. तो इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन और कंडक्शन, तो यहां पर हमने देखा कि दीज आर द टू ऑफ द वेज इन विच द फिलामेंट इज गोइंग टू बी लॉस्ट इट हिट. ऑन द अदर हैंड देर इज नो रोल ऑफ द कन्वेक्शन बिकॉज ऑफ फैक्ट दैट कि जो बल्ब के अंदर जो भी आप इज द एयर थी वो है हमने हटा दी है, पम्प्ड आउट ड्यूरिंग द मैन्युफैक्चर. जब हम बनाते हैं तो उसके दौरान हम क्या करते हैं, सो देर इज नो हीट लॉस बाय दिस कन्वेक्शन. सो हियर you can just see here, it is difficult to measure the temperature of the filament. अगर हम directly measure करें किसका filament का temperature, तो it is quite difficult for us. So first, what we do here, we, the filament resistance is proportional to its temperature. So हम directly क्या कर सकते हैं, temperature of filament directly हम measure नहीं करते, लेकिन उसके corresponding हम क्या कर सकते हैं, we can measure the filament resistance. And this is approximately proportional to its temperature. Approximately, क्योंकि आपने अभी मैंने बताया कोई linear relation है, R और T का, R is proportional to T. I will just show you how R is going to relate with the T. तो generally, I will just show you the graph as well. But आप यहाँ से समझिए कि जो temperature of the filament हम directly measure नहीं कर सकते हैं, लेकिन अगर if you have the filament resistance and it is having the approximately proportional to its temperature, we can just see here. Therefore, the filament resistance is used as a measure of filament temperature. तो actually क्या होता है, जो यहाँ पर filament resistance है, वो क्या है? It gives us the measurement of the filament temperature. And I will just show you the graph of electrical power against the resistance should be like this graph. I have just plotted for your convenience. This is the particularly graph. You can just see what I have shown here: electric power, which is expressed in watts, and it is corresponding with the resistance. You can just see here. तो इसके correspondence में मैंने आपको यहाँ पर दिखाया है कि इस तरह से हम क्या कर सकते हैं, we can have the relation in the electric power and the resistance, power versus resistance for the light bulb, जो हमने यहाँ पर utilize किया है radiating body के तौर पर. तो उसके लिए हमने यहाँ पर दिखाया है कि electric power और जो resistance है. अब generally you have to just note down at low temperatures, अगर हम इस portion की बात करें, at low temperature AB, most of the heat loss is by conduction. जो मेनली क्या हो रही है, हीट लॉस हो रही है लो टेम्परेचर पर, वो किसके द्वारा हो रही है, हीट लॉस इज बाय द कंडक्शन. एंड लिटिल ऑफ द हीट लॉस इज ड्यू टू रेडिएशन. मैंने अभी बताया कि जो हम जनरली बात करते हैं हीट लॉस जो हम यहाँ पर लेते हैं, वो दो, इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन के फॉर्म में हो सकता है या कंडक्शन के फॉर्म में हो सकता है. कन्वेक्शन के फॉर्म में तो हो ही नहीं सकता. मेनली टू वेज आर देयर, इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन एंड द कंडक्शन. तो फॉर एट लो टेम्परेचर अगर आप देखें इसके लिए ए बी, most of the heat loss is by conduction and a little of the heat is lost due to radiation. To jo yahan par hai, therefore this part of the graph is extrapolated to estimate the conducted power at higher temperatures. Since this is an extrapolation, dotted line se represent kiya hai, dotted line in this graph, so you can this In the region AB, the graph must be accurately measured. इस graph को हमें क्या करना चाहिए, accurately measure करना चाहिए. Now, radiated power, this can be simply the electric power minus the conducted power PQ, जो यहाँ पर मैंने दिखाया है. जो radiated power is simply the electric power minus the conducted power PQ of the graph. So this is the how power is going to be. Vary with the resistance. You can just see here. I have just shown by this graph. Now, you just see here. Stefan's law states that radiated power is proportional to the absolute temperature T raised to the fourth power of the equation. Generally, यहाँ पर से आपको पता है कि यहाँ पर भी generally power क्या है? वो Stefan's law के केस में generally क्या होती है? It is proportional to the fourth power of the absolute temperature. And we just take again. The log on the both sides, we can obtain this relation. Log of 10 P is proportional to 4 log of T here, which is shown by equation. We have just taken the log of the above equation, so we have this relation. And what we have learned that रेजिस्टेंस जो है वो किसके प्रोपोर्शनल हो गया था, इट इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू द फिलामेंट टेम्परेचर एंड दिस इज टी हियर. सो वी कैन जस्ट से हियर, क्योंकि हम डायरेक्टली मेजर नहीं कर सकते थे टेम्परेचर एंड, तो उसके लिए इफ यू जो जस्ट नो द रेजिस्टेंस, वी हैव जस्ट अर्लियर डिस्कस दैट रेजिस्टेंस इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द टेम्परेचर. सो दिस इज हियर द केस, आर इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू टी हियर. सो इफ यू जस्ट टेक लॉग ऑन द बोथ साइड्स, देन वी हैव log of r is proportional to log of t here. So from equation, this first equation, it is visible to you, log of p is proportional to 4 log of t. This is the first equation. And the second equation, which is coming from the proportionality of the resistance with respect to the filament temperature, it is shown here. If we just compare these two equations and eliminating this term temperature, we are what you can see here. This is the ratio of log P upon log R is equals to 4 here. जो रेशियो किसका है, पावर रेडिएटेड और रेजिस्टेंस का जो रेशियो है वो किसके बराबर आ रहा है, 4 के बराबर आ रहा है. Therefore, if we just plot a graph again, the radiated power against resistance with a gradient of 4 within the year in the gradient confirms the Stefan's law as it can be seen in the graph. This is the graph in which we have the radiated power and on the x-axis we have the resistance. You will just see there is the straight line and the slope of this will give us the value of 4, and this is the simply you just see here, this is the Stefan's law jo ko confirm karta hai. So this is the principle behind the discussion of the Stefan's law verification ko discuss karne ke liye. Ye principle ye aapko samajhna zaruri tha ki actually kya cheeze ho rahi hain. Mainly, these are the two things which I have to just consider here. Now, we just see the experimental setup. अब भाई experimental setup, क्योंकि हमें Stefan's law verification instrument की मैंने बात कही थी सबसे पहले वाली slide में, तो हमें battery थी, उसके साथ साथ क्या था, rheostat था, emitter था, bulb था, voltmeter था. तो generally, we have this particular arrangement for the Stefan's law verification. तो अगर आप देखें, और मैंने कहा था एक सिंगल कैबिनेट में, मतलब हम इसको इस तरह से क्या कर सकते हैं, वी कैन जस्ट हैव असेंबल्ड वेयर यू जस्ट सी एमिटर इज हियर, दिस इज वोल्टमीटर अलोंग विद दिस इज द रियोस्टेट चेंजिंग द रेजिस्टेंस हियर. सो दिस इज अ पर्टिकुलर, वी कैन जस्ट हैव द स्टीफन्स लॉ के लिए जो एक्सपेरिमेंटल सेटअप है, इसको एक बार और आप देख सकते हैं. दिस इज द रियोस्टेट, एमिटर, बैटरी एंड बल्ब and the voltmeter. So these things are required for the, and जो मैंने कहा था आपसे radiating body क्या है, कि हम यहाँ पर कोई अगर perfect black body, अगर हमें, क्योंकि हम एक ऐसी body मान रहे हैं जो क्या कर रही है, radiate कर रही है power. कि मैंने पहले ही कहा था कि it is suppose not black, then we have another radiating body. उसके लिए हमने P वाला formula लिखा था, P equals C times of T raised to power alpha minus T naught raised to power alpha. So what is the here, the bulb is the radiating body here. So this is the importance of here taking the bulb, because bulb is the radiating body in this Stefan's law verification. Now this is also visible to you, so we have this. Now how we can just proceed, hum isko experiment ko kaise karenge. So you can just see here, connections can be made. You just see here, I have just plot, or it is visible to you in this figure, the all the, this is bulb here, and in parallel there is the voltmeter, in the series ammeter, in there is the rheostat, and this is the all the components that I have explained earlier are here shown in the circuit diagram as well. So it is visible to you, aap dekh sakte hain, note kar sakte hain. To aapko generally bulb laga hua, uske parallel mein kya laga hua hai, voltmeter laga hua hai, uske sath kya hai, dc regulated power supply hai, uske sath sath kya hai, and you know that emitter is always connected in the series and voltmeter in parallel, and with this we have the rheostat here. So it is visible to you, this is the circuit diagram for the Stefan's law verification. Stefan's law ko verify karne ke liye proper circuit diagram aapko yaad hona chahiye jab aap experimental Stefan's law ko perform karenge. In order to connect voltmeter across the bulb, you can just see here two wires at the shoulders to the base of the points of the bulb here. So इस तरह से हमने क्या कर रखा है कि वोल्टमीटर को कनेक्टर कर रखा है किसके अक्रॉस, इस बल्ब के अक्रॉस जो आपको विजिबल है। अब क्या करेंगे, नाउ द नेक्स्ट थिंग व्हाट विल डू हियर विथ डिफरेंट इंक्रीजिंग एंड डिक्रीजिंग वैल्यूज ऑफ द करंट वी एडजस्ट सच दैट द बल्ब ग्लोज ईच टाइम। तो हम क्या करेंगे, वैल्यू ऑफ करंट को हम क्या करेंगे, किससे बढ़ाएंगे, विद द हेल्प ऑफ द रिस्टोर्स से हम वैल्यू ऑफ द करंट को क्या करेंगे, चेंज करेंगे। तो बल्ब क्या होगा, इफ इट इज वर्किंग फाइन, इट इज वर्किंग प्रॉपरली, देन क्या होगा, बल्ब ग्लो करेगा, बल्ब ग्लो हर समय करेगा, उसकी इंटेंसिटी क्या होगी, धीरे धीरे क्या होगी, पावर रेडिएशन ज्यादा होगा, क्योंकि जैसे जैसे करंट बढ़ेगी वैसे वैसे क्या होगा, उसकी जो ल्यूमिनिसिटी है, जो ग्लो है वो क्या होगा, बढ़ते जाएगा। तो फॉर दिस वी हैव द वोल्टेज V एंड I, एंड द रेशियो ऑफ दिस V अपॉन I इज फाउंड विच गिव्स RG, वो क्या देता है हमें, RG। सो व्हाट इज RG हियर, दिस इज द फिलामेंट रेजिस्टेंस, जैसे मैंने डिस्कस भी किया था RG की वैल्यू, दिस इज द व्हेन द बल्ब स्टार्ट्स ग्लोइंग, जब बल्ब क्या करता है, ग्लो करता है स्टार्ट, तो उस समय का जो टेम्परेचर है वो कितना होता है, ऑलमोस्ट इट इज 800 केल्विन हियर। सो दिस इज द प्रॉपर सर्किट डायग्राम एंड दिस इज द प्रोसेस। सबसे पहले हम क्या निकालेंगे, RG निकालेंगे। RG कब निकालेंगे, वी जस्ट टेक द जस्ट ग्लो कंडीशन और उसमें हम जस्ट ग्लो मीन्स वी विल इंक्रीज द करंट एंड करेस्पॉन्डिंग विद द बल्ब इज गोइंग टू बी ग्लो एंड दिस विल गिव अस द filament resistance and having noting down the values of this V and I we can determine RG. So it is visible to you, you can just see here, from here you can just see, from this here you can just see here, to hum isse kya kar sakte hain, we can just have this from RT upon R0 versus T graph, we note that jo hamare paas R800 upon R273 hai iski value kitni aati hai, 3.9 ke equal aati hai, जो रेशियो हम RT अपॉन R0 जो हम प्लॉट करते हैं विद रिस्पेक्ट टू किसके, टेम्परेचर के, तो दिस रेशियो कम्स आउट टू बी, यू कैन जस्ट सी हियर, इट कम्स आउट टू बी दिस 800 अपॉन दिस कम्स आउट टू बी 3.9। देयरफॉर दिस रेशियो वी कैन जस्ट फाइंड आउट R0, अगर हमें RG पता चल गया है विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस V अपॉन I, वी कैन जस्ट फाइंड आउट R0 कहां पर, दिस इज द फिलामेंट रेजिस्टेंस एट 0 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड। सो वी हैव दिस R0 एंड दिस R0 इज RG अपॉन 3.9 हियर। वी जस्ट हैव ए ग्राफ एंड बिटवीन RT अपॉन R0 वर्सेस द टेम्परेचर, इट इज ऑलरेडी प्रोवाइडेड टू द स्टूडेंट्स वेयर दे कैन जस्ट विद द रेशियो ऑफ दिस RT अपॉन R0 दे कैन नोट डाउन द प्रॉपर टेम्परेचर्स एज वेल। So it is already provided to the students, ये students को हम provide कर देते हैं, वो क्या करते हैं इसके RT upon R0 के ratio से वो corresponding temperatures note कर सकते हैं। Now the next thing, when we have determined R0, तो हमने RG निकाल लिया, R0 निकाल लिया by this formula, तो हम next क्या करेंगे, Now we have to see power, क्योंकि generally हमें क्या देखना है, power, क्योंकि temperature तो आपको यहाँ से आ गया, लेकिन power कहाँ से आएगी, This can be now filament current I is increased. हम क्या करेंगे, filament current को हम क्या करेंगे, increase करेंगे, कहां से, from a below glow state to a high enough value of getting dazzling light. You will just see here a dazzling light which measures the voltage V across the bulb every time. वो generally क्या करेगा, We can take the questions. Hello, ma'am. Hello. I am audible. Hello.
Yes, sir. You are audible, sir.
Okay. Thank you. We can take the questions at last. Someone is raising hand, so we can take the question at end. It will be okay.
Yes, sir. There's no question, sir. Okay.
Thank you. So, we can have. This dazzling light will is going to be produced and from these V and I values we can have the power. Power is V into I. So we can have, this is the proper formula. We can have, hum kya karenge? Current ki value ko increase karenge. Kahan se? From a below glow stage to a value high enough. I will just show you a video regarding this. So it will be much more clear how the experiment is going to be performed in the lab. So in this case, you can just see here, bulb is going to be glow every time. We just have the proper value of this voltage and the current. So we can just basic formula. What is it? When V is going to multiply it by this I, we have the power. We can just determine the power, and in correspondent with this, we can have the value of RT. RT is V upon I. Simply we can just find out what is the RT here. So from RT, using the values of R0, we have already calculated. You can just see here. R0 हमने calculate कर लिया था किससे? RG upon 3.9 से हमारे पास R0 आ गया, और यहाँ से हमने क्या calculate किया है? RT calculate कर लिया है. तो we can have this. RT की value हमारे पास आ गई है. We deduce the temperature T of the filament and we can have obtain a graph in log P against log T. तो हम क्या कर सकते हैं, log P और log T के बीच में हम क्या कर सकते हैं, we can just have a graph as well. So now students, I have a video regarding to show you how we can have the, you can just see here how the experiment is going to be performed in the lab. So generally हम उसको देख लेते हैं कैसे हम उसको हम परफॉर्म कर सकते हैं. मैम इट इज विजिबल. हेलो हेलो मैम.
यस सर
इट इज विजिबल.
यस सर इट इज विजिबल बट प्लीज प्ले इट सो दैट आई कैन.
ओके ओके आई एम जस्ट प्लेइंग इट. जस्ट टेल मी वेदर साउंड इज गोइंग टू बी प्रोड्यूस और नॉट.
ओके ओके फाइन सर यू जस्ट प्ले.
We will learn how to do the experiment, Stefan's law verification.
Yes, sir, it is fine.
Or do this experiment, we have the apparatus here. Now we will just proceed to the apparatus. What are the apparatus? Before discussing this, we have the, you can just see here, this is the circuit diagram for the Stefan's law verification. When we discuss Stefan's law verification, the components, you can just see here, what are the instruments? Rheostat, this is the battery, this is the bulb, this is emitter, and the, you can just see, voltmeter is connected in parallel with the bulb. This is here, all these components are, you can just see here, I have.
So students, I have just shown you, this is the particular arrangement for the circuit diagram, you can just see. Next,
here
see
in
how we can make circuit.
अब देखिए सर्किट कैसे जुड़ा हुआ है. देखिए सबसे पहले आप अगर आप यहां से देख सकें तो हम सबसे पहले दिस इज द बैटरी. बैटरी का एक टर्मिनल किसमें गया है, अगर आप देखें दिस इज कनेक्टेड विद द, ये आपका रियोस्टोर में गया है रियो, और एक और जो दूसरा वाला टर्मिनल है बैटरी का वो किसमें गया हुआ, दिस इज कनेक्टेड विद द बल्ब, यू कैन जस्ट सी हियर. उसी के साथ साथ अगर आप इसमें देखें तो और बल्ब का एक टर्मिनल किसमें गया हुआ, इस एमिटर में गया हुआ. एमिटर का एक टर्मिनल जैसा कि आपको यहां पर से दिख भी रहा है सर्किट में, इट इज कनेक्टेड विद द रियोस्टोर. सो दिस इज द, ये कॉम्बिनेशन है. उसके साथ साथ अगर आप यहां पर देखें तो इसमें क्या है, एक वोल्टमीटर लगा हुआ है. वोल्टमीटर का इस तरह से यहां पर कॉम्बिनेशन इस तरह से हमने लगा रखा है, एक बल्ब का एक टर्मिनल किससे लगा हुआ है, इस वोल्टमीटर से. दूसरा भी टर्मिनल जो वोल्टमीटर का वो कनेक्टेड किससे है, बल्ब से. तो बेसिकली ये आपको फिजिकली एक्सपेरिमेंट में जो कंपोनेंट्स यूज होते हैं उसके बारे में मैंने आपको बता दिया. इस कंपोनेंट्स को जान लिए, अब आपको परफॉर्म कैसे करना है, हमको कैसे वेरीफाई करना है. इन यू कैन जस्ट सी हियर दिस वन इज द रियोस्टेट. एंड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल what we have to just some introduction about the functionalities of this rheostat, emitter, voltmeter.
Dear students, ab hum kya thoda dekhenge ki kaise mainly what is the function of this instrument, in instrument ka function kaise kaam karte hain, matlab inko hum kaise use karte hain. So let's see here,
this is the bulb here and this one is the battery. First thing, I am just going to switch it on by giving some power here, and we have here battery. Just I am going to on, you can just see here the LED light, it is going to be here, you can just see here, now the power is on here. Now you can just see here rheostat. What is the basic functionality of rheostat? You can just say that rheostat actually hota kya hai, you can just say an electronic instrument used to control a current by varying the resistance. Now you can just see, in accordance with that, we have potentiometer as well. So पोटेंशियोमीटर रियोस्टेट से कैसे डिफरेंस होता है? पोटेंशियोमीटर यू कैन जस्ट से इट इज ए स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ द रियोस्टेट. अब एक्चुअली पोटेंशियोमीटर, व्हेन वी डिस्कस पोटेंशियोमीटर, इज ए थ्री टर्मिनल रेजिस्टेंस विद स्लाइडिंग और रोटेटिंग कॉन्टैक्ट दैट फॉर्म्स एन एडजस्टेबल वोल्टेज डिवाइडर. इफ ओनली देर आर टू टर्मिनल्स आर यूज वन एंड एंड द वाइपर, it acts as a variable resistor or the rheostat. So you can just say, ab generally rheostat, you can just say, typically handle high level of voltage and current than potentiometer. So rheostat ki applicability yahan par badh jati hai ki we have the high levels of the voltage and the current can be handled with the help of the rheostat. And that's why it is widely used. You just see in the industrial applications, rheostat is mainly going to be widely used. Now we just come to the...
students, I have hope you have learned about what is the basic function of the rheostat. Now we just go into
this battery. You can just say we have the cell configuration. Agar aap cell ki baat kare to cell kya hota hai, there are, this one is the positive terminal indicated by the longer, you can just see here this line, and this is the negative. This is the cell configuration, positive and negative. These are, you can just say, these are the terminals, positive terminal and negative. When we discuss a battery, you can just see here, I have represented a battery. Battery is represented by, you can just see here, by this configuration. What is actually meaning? So battery ko agar aap is tarah se samjhe, to battery is a combination of the cells. Battery kya hai actually? Ye cell ka combination hai. There are more than ones. There are, generally you can just see, this is the formation of the battery. In accordance with this, we have the ammeter. What is the ammeter? You can just say, ammeter is an instrument for measuring the strength of current in an electrical circuit. Actually, ammeter, and you know that the ammeter, jo current hum kis mein measure karte hain? Ampere mein karte hain. That's why its name is ammeter. In accordance with this, you can just see here, what is it? It is the voltmeter. What is the basic functionality of the voltmeter? You can just say, it is also an instrument which is used for measuring electrical potential difference between two points in an electrical circuit. In accordance with this, we have also discussed battery, this is rheostat, ammeter, and voltmeter. Now you just see here, this is the, when we discuss the Stefan's law verification, what is the radiating body? Radiating body is this bulb, which is going to radiate. Power radiated is by this bulb. And you just see here, the bulb is going to glow here. Glow because of there is having the tungsten filament inside the bulb. What is the, why there is the tungsten filament? So you can just see here, tungsten filament is in the sense that it have a very high melting point and it have high temperature resistance as well and low thermal expansion here. That is the applicability of using tungsten inside the bulbs. In normal, when we have ordinary bulbs, when we use, except of nowadays, we are widely using lead. But few years back, in all the homes, we have generally the bulbs which produce yellowish light. So there inside that there is a tungsten filament, and tungsten filament is used because it is inactive towards the inert gases as well, and you can just say here because of the high melting point. So I have discussed the what are the components and what are the functionality. Now we just come,
students, यहाँ तक तो आप समझ गए होंगे कि हम मतलब बेसिक जो इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स इसमें यूज हो रहे हैं, रियोस्टोट की बात कर ली हमने, एमिटर की बात कर ली, वोल्टमीटर की बात कर ली, साथ ही साथ हमने इसमें भी ये देखा कि बैटरी कैसे है और क्या क्या हम इसमें बल्ब जो है रेडिएटिंग बॉडी है, तो हम उसको कैसे मतलब यहाँ हम अरेंजमेंट करते हैं, कैसे कनेक्शन देते हैं, तो यहाँ तक तो समझ लिया. नाउ अब देखिए आप, जनरली हम कैसे रीडिंग्स लेते हैं, तो जनरली वी विल जस्ट फोकस ऑन हाउ वी जस्ट टेक द readings regarding the experiment.
To the how we perform experiment inside the room, practical room. So this is the basic arrangement. Now we have just switch on. Now what we will just see here, you can just see, now we are going to discuss here, first we are just determination of RG, which is the temperature of the filament. First, so hum kya karenge, we will just first a condition when just बल्ब इज गोइंग टू जस्ट ग्लो कंडीशन, जस्ट ग्लो कंडीशन यू कैन जस्ट सी हियर.
तो स्टूडेंट सबसे पहले अगर आप यहाँ देखें तो हम क्या कर रहे हैं, सबसे पहले हमें आरजी निकालना है. तो आरजी अभी मैंने बताया इंक्रीजिंग और डिक्रीजिंग कई बुक्स में दिया हुआ है, जैसे गुप्ता कुमार की जो बुक है उसमें आप इंक्रीजिंग और डिक्रीजिंग करंट. तो जनरली हम क्या करते हैं, इतना लंबा ना करके जनरली हम क्या करते हैं, वी डिटरमाइन ए सिंपल वैल्यू ऑफ द वोल्टेज एंड द करंट फॉर द डिटरमिनेशन ऑफ द आरजी विच करेस्पॉन्ड्स टू द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द फिलामेंट. सो दिस ओनली वन वैल्यू इज सफिशियंट फॉर द डिटरमिनेशन ऑफ आरजी एज आई हैव शोन यू दिस वन. So you just see,
I am just increasing the current, you can just see with the help of the rheostat, you can just see in accordance with us, this bulb is going to be glow here. So we will just accept a condition when it is just glow. You can just see here, it is, if it is visible to you, now you can just see here, it is going.
आप यहाँ पर देख रहे हैं कि ये बल्ब क्या कर रहा है, ग्लो कर रहा है. तो जनरली हम इसी कंडीशन मतलब जहां से बल्ब ग्लो स्टार्ट मतलब जहां से ग्लो स्टार्ट होगा उसी वहीं पर क्या होगी, उस पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू वी और आई के लिए हम डिटरमाइन करेंगे आरजी की वैल्यू.
ल्यूमिनेसिटी इज गोइंग टू बी हाई व्हेन जस्ट ग्लो कंडीशन. जस्ट ग्लो कंडीशन मींस जब ये जस्ट ग्लो स्टार्ट होगा मींस, तो यू कैन जस्ट सी हियर वी विल नोट डाउन द पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू ऑफ दिस करंट एंड द वोल्टेज. सो वी कैन जस्ट सी हियर दिस इज द प्रॉपर वैल्यू ऑफ द दिस वोल्टेज, इट इज 0.8 एंड द करंट विद इट इज जस्ट गोइंग टू बी इन दिस विद द हेल्प ऑफ एमीटर वी हैव नोटेड डाउन इट इज 0.12 एंड आरजी दिस इज द you know that this is the temperature of the filament when just bulb is glowing. So you can just see here RG is V upon I. So we have calculated this comes out to be 6.6 ohm. In accordance with this we have to also calculate this R0.
So generally students aap dekhiye apne RG calculate kar liya hai, to R0 ko nikalne ke liye generally which is the resistance of this filament I 0 we have this RG upon 3.9. to humne jo RG 6.6 jaisa ki aap dekh rahe hain and we have to just divide by 3.9, so we have the corresponding value for this which will determine the R0. So this comes out to be 1.69 as you can, and the units is ohm, so you can just note down. Now let's see,
and it can be found out with the help of this RG upon this 3.9. actually you can just see here this is the value of RG. It is just when it is divided by this 3.9, we have this 1.69 ohm. It is coming out to be the value of R0. First, we have to determine RG. Then we have to calculate R0. This is 1.69 ohm. It is just coming out to be. So this is the first table we have to prepare. Now on the other we have to also see, actually Stefan's law can be verified only when we have to just plot a graph between log P and log T. Why we are doing so? Because we are considering here P is C T to the power alpha, and what is Stefan's law? Is sigma T to the power 4. If we just take log on the both side, this is log P, this one is log C plus this, you can just say alpha log of T here. By the initial conditions, this value is coming out to be 0, and we are left with this is delta log of P upon this del log of T here. So we can just see here, we have the value of this delta log of P upon this delta log of T here. So you can just see here power radiated, energy emitted, this is C, it is constant, it is also constant, T is the absolute temperature, it is also the temperature. What is alpha here? Alpha is 4 here. So from when we just plot by the values of this log P and this here log T, this comes out to be straight line, and the value of this alpha nearly comes out to be 4 here. It means it comes closer to 4 than our Stefan's law is verified. So just consist on this table 2 in which we are just going to determine the power radiated for different temperatures. For doing this, in the previous case when we are discussing the RG, we are consisting only one value, and one value is that just glow condition, or the means when the bulb is just
students इस जब सबसे पहले हम आरजी की वैल्यू निकाल लेते हैं, जनरली हम क्या देख रहे थे, वी वेयर कंसिस्टिंग ओनली जस्ट ग्लो कंडीशन. लेकिन जब हम सेकंड वाली टेबल हम प्रिपेयर कर रहे हैं जिसमें हम पावर डिसिपेटेड फी फॉर द डिफरेंट टेम्परेचर्स टी हम नोट डाउन कर रहे हैं, तो उसके लिए जनरली यू विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द इनिशियल. इनिशियल मीन्स I have just started from 0.6. So generally you will start from the minimum value and you will reach to the maximum glow. Minimum means minimum glow या minimum जो filament तो क्या करेगा glow करेगा, लेकिन हमें minimum से start करके maximum glow तक जाना है. तो हमें minimum जो power है वहाँ से हमें क्या करना है maximum, तो वो उसको note down करना है. I mean I hope you have understand. हमें क्या करना है minimum जो glow है वहाँ से हमें maximum glow तक जाना है. So let's see.
Blowing. Now on the other hand, when we are going to determine power dissipated, means either you just see the bulb is either glowing. Glowing means what is happening? There is power radiated. Power is going to be radiated. So you can just see here, we have the current. Now this can be achieved by increasing the value of the current. And by this change the current, there is a corresponding this voltage is going to be developed by the change in the current. So you can just see here with the help of this. Now I am just going to, you can just see here, this is I am just going, and you can just see here what is going to be happen here. This bulb starts glowing, and you just see here it is going to produce a dazzling light.
जैसे कि आपने देखा पहले ग्लो हो रहा था, फिर उसके बाद हमने क्या किया और करंट अगर बढ़ा दी तो मैक्सिमम ग्लो आ गया. तो हमें क्या करना है इनिशियली मतलब हमें मिनिमम से करेस्पॉन्ड करके हमें मैक्सिमम ग्लो देखना, मींस मैक्सिमम हमें पावर रेडिएशन अचीव होंगे.
Current is going to be increased. So we will start from the minimum value of the current to up to the maximum value of the current. And corresponding, we will just note down the particular voltages. So we have this voltage, then we have this current, then you can just note down in this case. आप क्या करेंगे दिस आर टी यू कैन जस्ट फाइंड आउट विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस वी अपॉन आई देन यू विल हैव आर टी अपॉन आर जीरो देन दिस इज टेम्परेचर टी इन केल्विन फ्रॉम द ग्राफ एंड दिस यू विल हैव लॉग टी एंड यू विल जस्ट फाइंड आउट पावर पी इज वी इन टू आई देन यू विल हैव लॉग पी हियर सो जस्ट गोइंग टू जस्ट हाउ वी कैन जस्ट अचीव दिस तो जनरली यू कैन जस्ट सी हियर आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू find out means the bulb is starts here again glowing and we just note down suppose this in this case here the voltage it is just you can just have suppose I am taking on this 0.6 this is the first reading and for this I have to just measure out the current you can just see here from the current this is here it is 0.2 and there are 10 divisions corresponding to this 10 divisions are equal to 0.2 one division will represent 0.2 upon this 10 means 0.02 ampere will the one division will correspond and you can just see here I have just have this value of the voltage 0.6 for this corresponding I have obtained the current which is just coming out to be I can just note down with the help of this ammeter it is just coming out to be this is 0.12 and then we have RT this is a resistance RT we can just find out RT is V upon I so this value comes out to be this it is 5.0 then we will have RT upon R0 we have already calculated which was coming out to be as you can just note down it is coming out to be 1.69 so what will do we will divide RT by R0 so we will divide 5 by 1.69 and its value is coming out to be 2.95 and now this is already provided to the students this is the RT upon R0 versus temperature
graph. You just see this table already provided to the student so they can have the corresponding you just see here RT upon R0 ka 1 likha hai 1.53 2.0 se these are the corresponding ratio and for that corresponding ratio we can determine suppose ratio is coming out to be 3.8 suppose so the corresponding temperature will be 500 and we will add 500 plus 273 so the corresponding temperature will be changed into Kelvin so this is the utility of providing the this RT upon R0 versus T graph in the Stefan's law verification let's see
graph here so you can just see here this 2.95, you just see here, it is just close to, you can just note down, it is close to this 400, but this temperature is in degree centigrade. We have to just measure down in Kelvin. How we can do that? By adding 273 in degree centigrade, we can change the degree centigrade temperature into the Kelvin. You can just do here, temperature, corresponding temperature is coming out to be Kelvin. You can just see here 2.95, this is 400 plus 273, then it is 673. Now log T can be obtained. You just have to just proper information how we just have the log. So its value comes out to be this 2.82. Why 2? Because it is 3 digits. Now this is 2 point and this we have the log T value. Now power can be calculated, simple formula we are studying from, you know, class 9th or except earlier, we are studying that what is the basic formula of power calculating? Voltage and the current gives us the power in volts. So we have the potential V and the current I. So we can have this value 0.6 when multiplied by 0.12, this is 0.072, and the corresponding log value, this comes out to be 1.14 here. So this is the one table I have just prepared for your information that we do from this year. Suppose, and the reading, you will just take, I have just by 0.6 I have just taken, then we can go to 1.2. I will just show in the table, I have tabulated and correspondingly I have shown all the values. Now suppose, just this is the proper information, how we just calculate, this is the minus values, in the plus values will also be obtained. Suppose I am consisting on the voltage, suppose this is, I am just giving it 4.8 volt, suppose. In corresponding means, you can just proceed by when we will reach 4.8. For that, the corresponding current, I have noted down, this is 0.40. It is just coming out to be, and you know that RD is, we can just calculate by V upon I, this is 12 here. Then RD upon R0, 12 will be divided by 1.69. Then you can just note down, this comes out to be 7.10. And now, 7.10, you can just see here, it is nearest to, we can have the information, it is just nearest to this 6.94. So the corresponding temperature degree centigrade is 1000 we will add into this 273 to convert into Kelvin, we will have the value 1273 here. So this is the corresponding temperature. We will just take the log of this temperature and it comes out to be this 3.10 here. This is log T, and again we will have power. You can just note down, this V into I means 4.8 multiplied by 0.40, it comes out to be 1.92, and the corresponding log T value for this 1.92 comes out to be 0.28. so similarly you can just take all the values of V and I by corresponding, just see here, by corresponding increasing the value of the current and up to the maximum glow, up to the, you just see a dazzling light of the bulb up to the maximum glow. Actually what the bulb is in this case is the radiating body, and when we increase the current, bulb is going to radiate more and more as the you can just see the power is going to be increased, radiating power is going more and more as the we just increase the current. So in this case we will just do by this, we will just have the log P and log T. Now I have already shown to you, we will just plot a graph between this is log T and this one is log P here. So you can just see here, aap agar isko dekhen, toh we will just make a table for log P and log T, it comes out to be straight line, and the slope, this delta log of P upon log of T comes out to be 4, and it will nearly comes out to, suppose it is coming out to be 3.6 or 3.9, it is okay because we are nearest to the value of this 4, because of there may be some practical limitations or power loss or taking some error, there may be some errors, so the value will not correctly to the 4, but we will have the value nearest to this value of the 4. So we can just say that this is the verification of the Stephen's law while we just performed in the experiment in the lab. So I hope you have learned, and I hope that this must have been useful by showing you the how we just perform experiment in the classroom or the lab. So I think it will be very much helpful in understanding the practical, and I have just tell you the, all the components which are going to be used step by step, and explaining what are the functions of the all the, you can just see the components is going to be used. So students, thank you, thanks a lot, and thanks for your attention.
So students, I think you have just now we just come to the original one. Just I have just shown you how we just perform the experiment in the lab. So I have just shown all the values. I have just shown to you earlier while I am just showing you the video. So this is the value of R0. Now you can just see here, this is the second table which we have to just prepare. When you just see here, I have just taken all the values for your convenience. I have just taken 0.6, 1.2, 1.8. Meaning to say that मैंने क्या किया, minimum value से up to we are approaching to the maximum value. Meaning to say that maximum glow तक हम क्या करेंगे, क्योंकि हमारा जो यहाँ पर rotating body क्या है, वो है filament of the bulb, which is of the tungsten filament. तो generally वो क्या करेगा, glow कर रहा है, means power is going to be radiated. तो उसके corresponding में हमने क्या कर लिया, we have this log T, we have just note down, and log P हमारे पास आ गया corresponding with the power. Generally, you will just see here. देखिए जैसे यहाँ पर आ रहा है 5.46. उसके लिए corresponding temperature कितना लिखा हुआ है 1073. This is in Kelvin. So we just provide the students. हम क्या करते हैं कि एक table provide कर देते हैं. So students क्या कर सकते हैं? RT upon R0 के ratio से students can find out the corresponding temperature. So I just show you. This is the corresponding table we just provide to the students. जैसा कि मैंने आपको video में भी दिखाया था. तो जनरली हमारे पास जैसे सपोज रेशियो आ रहा है, सपोज 4.5, सपोज ये तो 4.4 है, सपोज 4.9 समथिंग आ रहा है. तो यू कैन जस्ट सी हियर, दिस इज नियरेस्ट टू 5, एंड यू कैन जस्ट हैव दिस वैल्यू. यू विल ऐड टू प्लस 273 इन 700 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड, देन द करेस्पॉन्डिंग टेम्परेचर विल बी चेंज इन टू केल्विन. मीनिंग टू से दैट फॉर दिस 4.94 यू कैन जस्ट टेक द करेस्पॉन्डिंग टेम्परेचर इन द टेबल, यू कैन नोट डाउन 973 here. So you just see here, we have just have this value. So यहाँ से हम क्या करेंगे, इसका log ले लेंगे, उसके corresponding हम क्या करेंगे, log P ले लेंगे. तो generally you just see here, there are some negative values in correspondence with that. When we increase the power, we have the positive values as well. तो हम क्या करते हैं, generally हम log T और log P की value हम इस तरह से निकालते हैं, क्योंकि हमें generally क्या करना है, log P और log T के बीच में एक graph खींचना है, और वो graph क्या आना चाहिए, उसकी value 4 के equal आनी चाहिए. तो generally you just see here, I have just plotted the, I have just taken the values of log T and log P here. So you just see here, I have taken 13 values. You can just take more values, it depends on you. But I have just shown how the, what is the characteristic behavior of this graph. So I have just taken only these values. So you just see here, this is the table which I have earlier discussed. This is provided already to the students. So can thus we have the particular temperature with the ratio of RT upon R0 here. Now, this is the one important with how Stephen's law can be confirmed. It can be confirmed or verified only when we just plot a graph. Plot a graph between log T and log P. We just plot a graph, it comes out to be this shape, means this is the straight line. And the corresponding slope of this log P and log T will give us the value of, you can just say here, iski kiski value dega hame? Iske correspondence, you can just see here, this will give us the value of alpha. And according to this slope, you can just see here, what is here delta log of P? It is 0.15. And what is here? 0.04. So you just see here, according to the slope, the value of this is coming out to be 3.75. According to my plot, as you can just see here, the value of this is coming out to be this 3 points same bar. Now I have earlier told you it is quite close to 4, so we can just say this is quite okay. And one thing, students, when we just plot a graph, one thing you have to just consider the scale. And because you just see any of the map, हम कभी भी मैप देखते हैं जल्दी, उसमें भी क्या होता है 1 centimeter correspond to 10 kilometer 100 kilometer. तो जल्दी हमें जब भी हम ग्राफ की बात करेंगे तो ग्राफ में स्केल का लिखना बहुत जरूरी होता है. तो स्केल के लिए हम जल्दी क्या कहते हैं, एक्स एक्सिस और वाई एक्सिस के करेस्पॉन्डिंग वी जस्ट नोट वी कैन हैव हमें इन्फॉर्मेशन, क्योंकि आप किसी को दूसरे को अगर दिखाएंगे तो उसको जल्दी इन्फॉर्मेशन कैसे मिलेगी वेन वी जस्ट राइट डाउन द प्रॉपर स्केल अबाउट द पर्टिकुलर ग्राफ. सो it is just shown to you, I have mentioned the scale as well. So this is the one important thing to learn all the students. Now you will just see, I have just plotted a graph as well, RT upon R0 versus temperature. What this signifies? This signifies the corresponding temperatures. Means जैसे अपनी RT upon R0 का एक graph खींचेंगे with respect to temperature, तो उसके corresponding आप जैसे particular values, जैसे 4 point, जैसे ग्राफ में जनरली टेबल में क्या दिया हुआ है, अगर आप टेबल में देखें तो जनरली 3.22 के लिए दिया हुआ है लेकिन 3.45 के लिए नहीं दिया हुआ है. तो जनरली क्या कर सकते हैं, व्हेन वी जस्ट प्लॉट ए ग्राफ बिटवीन आरटी अपॉन R0 और टेम्परेचर के बीच में जब ग्राफ खींचेंगे तो पर्टिकुलरली क्या करेंगे, आरटी अपॉन R0 का जो रेशियो होगा, तो उस 3.45 सपोज इसमें जनरली मेंशन नहीं है 3.45, तो हम क्या करेंगे जनरली इस अगर इनके बीच में लाई करेगा तो मतलब करेस्पॉन्डिंग टेम्परेचर उसी के आसपास होगा, तो हम वो टेम्परेचर स्पेसिफिक वैल्यूज के लिए नोट डाउन कर सकते हैं. तो दिस इज द एप्लीकेबिलिटी ऑफ प्लॉटिंग दिस ग्राफ आरटी अपॉन R0 वर्सेस टेम्परेचर. नाउ द रिजल्ट, एज यू कैन जस्ट सी हियर, वी हैव जस्ट प्लॉटेड ग्राफ बिटवीन लॉग पी एंड लॉग टी विच कम्स आउट टू बी ए स्ट्रेट लाइन, एंड हेंस वी कैन जस्ट सी बाय द मेथड we have the power p is equal to c t to the power alpha, law is verified, and the slope of the straight line was coming out to be, is coming out to be, this is close to 4. As in this case we can just see here what is the result of our, this is 3.74. it is quite close to the, when we just plot a graph between log p and log t, it comes out to be 3.74, means we have performed experiment quite correctly. So this is the Stefan's law verification, and it has been verified as the fourth power law. So this is the result here. And what are the precautions to be taken? Means we can get accurate resistance at a particular temperature. V and I, jo voltage or current ki value kya honi chahiye, we should note every time after achieving the steady state. And thus the slope of the straight line should be determined as accurate as possible, because the values should come out to be near to the 4. So hame jo graph plotting hai ya jo slope hum nikalne hai straight line ki help se, to kya hona chahiye jaldi, wo aapka accurate aana chahiye with the help of the methods you employ for determining the slope here. So thank you.